Let's understand the solar heat gain calculations. That is the second factor which contributes to our solar gains. One of the solar gain obviously comes through the walls and roof. But over here, the more important factor is the solar gain through windows. And why do we need to consider? That's because the solar radiations which are coming from sun, the thermal radiations can actually transmit through the windows, because those are clear windows. Those are not the opaque substance. Hence, they can pass through and they can directly lead to the heating. So if there's a solar radiation coming through, and if this is a glass, then it is going to pass through the glass. And if there's something, some objects inside our building, it could be sofa set, furniture, anything, it is directly going to heat up that. So this factor, contribution from the solar loads should be considered. So we are now going to take into account the solar loads. And that's the second factor. Second type of major heat load inside our building, and solar load calculations maybe to go right. And over here, I'll directly start with taking some numbers so you get some basic idea of how to do all the calculations and solve a problem. And let's start with that. So as we did for the transmission, we know that it's going to come through the walls, windows, roof, and all. Over here, the solar loads are always going to come through the windows. Let's save some space, and it's going to be always through the glass. So not like just take windows for our account, it will be all the glass area. And glass area will include the windows and the doors. Also take into account the emergency doors, emergency exits. But these are the two things which we'll always take into account. And what we want is, how do we express the amount of solar load through these two, the window and door will be. My solar load Q will be solar heat gain factor into area and summation of it, right? That's a very simple thing. Let's put it to be more clear for us. We can also take into account the other two factors. And let me just define all of this. So SHGF is solar heat gain factor, right? The area, we always know that's the area of the windows and doors. That's the glass area basically in each orientation. And we'll go into the procedure of calculating all, and this orientation things will be more clear to you. The PPS is also an important factor, which is percentage possible sunshine, and K is the color correction factor. And we'll go into the importance of all of these factors. What SHGF represents is, it's the amount of solar heat gain which is happening through the windows or the glass on a clear day and through a window or a glass which is 1/8 thickness, glass which is 1/8 inch thick, and it is a clear day and it is a clear glass. So if it is not a clear day, there are some clouds and all, we'll take into account this factor, which is PPS, which says percentage possible sunshine, and that will take into account if there are clouds and all. So if there are 50% of the sky is covered with clouds, then we'll maybe take it the PPS to be 50%, which is 0.5 in our calculations. So for summer, usually my PPS is taken to be 0.64. Sorry, I made an error there. And this is the PPS value, not the summer value. For summer, and 0.44 for winters. So 6 months will have an approximate PPS value average to be 0.64. And the other 6 months roaming around winter season will take a PPS average value of 0.44. And this can change based on location. These are the a general value. K is the color correction factor that comes into account, because if we have a black object inside our room, it is going to absorb more heat. If it is a white object, white colored on the surface, it is going to absorb less heat. That's what we already know from our basics. So that will take into account that the different colors of our objects inside the room, it's inside the furniture, sofa set, everything. This K value will take into account those things. And these values are also available in S-ray chart. So for SHGF and K, we need to look at the S-ray charts. Now let's come into SHGF. That's one of the important thing we want to have values of. So there are no calculations involved. SHGF values depend on a couple of things, couple of factors, and the standard values for this are already available in our S-ray handbooks. So the SHGF are going to depend on the location of my building. That means the degree north, the orientation of my building. So for all the standard 8 orientations of my building, such as north, northeast, northeast, east, southeast, and all, let's put down all of those, southwest, west, northwest, and that's all. These are 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 orientations possible. These are the 8 standard orientations. Then we have an horizontal orientation also. Let's put down that also, because that are the sun rays coming flat, horizontal with respect to the surface of Earth. The next is time of day. That means it's start of the, it's 8 a.m. or 1 p.m. or maybe, so for each hour from 8 a.m., 9 a.m. or for each of the time of the day, for each hour of the day, the values are available for SHGF. Then the next thing is the month of year, and these are the 4 factors which will contribute to the SHGF values. So what do we have is, we have a chart available to us, and what will it say is, let's say the chart would have a specific orientation. So where I live is, it is 32 degree north. So there would be chart different charts available for 32 degrees, 30 degrees, 40 degrees, etc. Then it would say the other important would be the month of the year. So month or date, it could be date. So it might say 22nd July. That's one of the longest day, I think. I don't remember specifically, but it could say a specific date. And then for the orientation and time of the day, it could list down in the table format. So it can start at 6 a.m. So 6 o'clock. Let's put in the standard ways. Then 8, and it can go down to 12, 13, and it can go down to 16, 17, 18. That means 6 p.m. This is 18 hours, that is 6 p.m. This is 6 hours, that means 8 a.m. And then column wise, I can have values for north, northeast, northwest, west, and everything there. So that's how a table looks like. And what do we have? There could be values. So over here, it could be 100. Or for northeast direction, it could be 50, 70, 30, 20, 80, 100, anything. And at 1 p.m., the values could rise up to higher values. So maybe at 1 p.m., 13 hours is equivalent to 1 p.m. And that means the sun is almost at the top, at the highest peak. So the values could rise to 700, 400, 600, 800. And these are different orientations, what I am listing. These are random values. And then what do we need to do is, we need to sum all this. So over here at the end, we can have a half day total. We'll have half day totals over there. So what we need to do is, we need to sum up this. And what's the important factor is, the half day totals should match the opposite direction. So if we see the north and the south, the half day totals should have equal values, right? So we'll use the half day totals of SHGF. These are the total SHGF. For those half days on individual directions. So for our building, which was taken in the previous video on transmission loads, let's say we have four orientations, which are north, south, east, and west. And along this four orientation, the areas are available to me. And the area in north direction is 60. The area in south direction is 60 feet square. East is 48 and west is 48 feet square. And that's not the standard, the same building which we took in the previous case. It is another building, another sample building. And then what we need, let's make the table slightly on another side here. So what we have is to calculate the Q value, we need SHGF into area into PPS into K. So let's say PPS and K values are going to be constant. It doesn't change. So with the different orientations, the areas could be changed. So we need to find out the total value of SHGF into area for the building. So let's say we have four orientations of our building, north, east, west, and south. And for these four orientations, my areas of window, glass area, is given as north has 60, south has 60, then other two has 48, and it's in feet square, right? Now let's look at the SHGF. So for SHGF, we need to take the two half day totals. So for north direction, we'll take this half day. So if it is full day, then it is, if it is from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. or maybe whatever the total column is, then it is a full day total, and we'll take the whatever value is at the bottom, the summation of all this total during the day. For north direction, we'll put the value over here. For south direction, we'll, whatever this, the total, we'll put down the value over here. For east and west, we'll separately look and take these total values. But if I have a chart which is running from 6 a.m. to 12, and then from 13 to 18 it is not available, that means it is complementary. This half day total, this is half day for me, this is another half day for me. So that the half day totals are available, then we need to add the half days. What does that mean is, let's say this is the half day for me till here, then the value for north in the half day, for the first half of the day, this is the north. For the other half of the day, the south becomes the north. So for north direction, what we'll add is, we'll take this value plus this value, and that becomes my north. And obviously for south also, I'll take this value, and the complementary is this. So north and south will have the same values. And if we read the full day totals also, it should come out that to be the same. So let's say my values for, I have a chart for 21st. I have values for 21st December. And the values available to me are for North, it is 142. For East, it is 571. For West, it is 571. And for South, it is 1704. Okay. So for East and West, those values are coming to be equal. For North and South, they are not equal. That is because if we have a building in the Northern Hemisphere, then as the sun rotates, if I have a building in the Northern Hemisphere, let's say, the south side of the building is going to gain more heat. It's going to face more sunshine. It's going to get more radiations. North side is going to get relatively very low amount of radiations. And hence, the north side should have a low SHGF value. South side should have large SHGF. This is one of the check we can make while we do the calculations. Now, the very simple thing is, we'll have SHGF into the area. These values should come out, some calculation, and that comes out to be something for me. I don't have these values, but it's going to be very simple a calc. Now for Q, what do I need is, I have this summation, so this value is my summation of SHGF into area, and this value I need to use over here into PPS. So for December, my PPS value could be 0.44 into K depends, and it could be 0.8 for some other colors, a mix of colors. So average value could be 0.8, and that's how I can take out and see my Q solar could come out to be somewhere equal to 3450 BTU per hour. Okay, so I hope you have got a very much understanding of how to do the calculations, how to read the chart, get the SHGF values, make the multiplications, and get the value of my Q solar. In the next video, we'll go through the internal loads, the occupant loads, and the electrical load calculations. Okay, so thank you.